Scott, that list of players that have had their numbers retired by two separate teams is pretty stellar. What does it feel like to be on a list that epic?
Yeah, obviously when they announced it, people were talking about that a little bit. I didn't really know that, obviously, going into this. But, a lot of guys I looked up to on that list I grew up idolizing and watching play. And, to see my name on that list, I don't know, one doesn't maybe fit so well. But anyway, it fits.
I'll say it
so
for you.
I appreciate that. like I said, I looked up to a lot of those guys. Played against a few of them when I did get into the league, and some of the older guys that when you're a kid, those are the names that you thought about when you thought about hockey. So to be part of that group is pretty special, but my time here in Anaheim and for them to honor me in that way obviously means a lot too.
Something else that I know is very special to you in your playing days is I had the honor of being able to play with you in New Jersey and being able to hoist Stanley Cup with you, but then you go on to play with your brother Rob. And maybe talk about how special that moment was, and maybe through that process of getting out there. Did you ever think it would even come to this, and you get to hoist another cup there and win that with your brother?
Yeah, I guess we would say we would love to do it, but did we think it would happen? That might have been a bit of a stretch. When we played each other in the Stanley Cup final in 2003, and actually I think my brother brings your name up a few times. I believe you had a good game 7 in that series, and he's always blaming you for losing that that playoff series. But, that was tough. It was hard to kind of, see how disappointed he was losing that. I was excited, obviously, to win, but it was a pretty mixed, a lot of mixed emotions, needless to say. And then a few short years later to be able to team up, end up playing together in the NHL was special enough, and unbelievable that 2 years after I went out to Anaheim that we won a Stanley Cup together. It's pretty crazy, really. It's still somewhat hard to believe that it all worked out like that.
And you spent a few years too in Anaheim with that organization. What can you say about sort of your time with the organization and how much hockey has grown in Anaheim since that team got there?
Yeah, it's been neat to see. I didn't really know what to expect when I came out here. The team had just been sold, hired new general manager, new coaching staff. So there was a lot of sort of unanswered questions coming out here. And I couldn't have asked really for a better situation. Some great veteran players that I got to play with, some young guys that came in and obviously improved our team, the friends we made. And then obviously with my kids growing up here, playing hockey, I've kind of got to see how hockey has grown at the youth level and that sort of thing. So it's been a fun time out here in California. It was a hard decision at the time, actually. Watching John Tavares go through sort of his decision-making process was kind of brought back some memories of what it was like to leave New Jersey. It wasn't an easy decision, but fortunately, it worked out well here in Anaheim.
Well, Needs, I want to ask you and just get your perspective, because it was a little different from your teammates. And some of us joke around, and I joked around about it with Patty Aliash a couple months ago. And anytime we have teammates and your name comes up, I remember sitting in the locker room, and I'd maybe only play 8 or 9 minutes a night. And in between periods, I'm changing my shirt because it's so drenched, and I've got the sweat around my ears. And Scott Niedermayer
literally—
You're not giving
me a good image
but everybody else on the team team is dripping, like sweating and struggling to maintain themselves. And you look across the room, Scott Niedermayer's hair's feathery, light, no sweat. He's got about a dime-shaped sweat drop on his chest. And it looks so easy for you, but maybe you could just tell us from your perspective, what things were easy and what things were difficult for you playing in the National Hockey League?
Well, it was a bit of a curse, not being a guy that sweated a lot. I'd get off after practice or games, and the coaches definitely wouldn't be too impressed by that. But, I think what it really stemmed to a little bit, part of it anyway, was just sort of, my strength as a skater was just being efficient, and sort of the way I skated, the way I moved around the ice. I'd look over and maybe I'd be playing with Colin White or Ken Danico, and they were probably working a lot harder to get from A to B than I was. So I was fortunate that, I had that talent and skill to be able to help me while I was out there.
You're like the opposite of Kevin Weeks. He can't stop sweating.
No.
Even when he's just in studio. You mentioned John Tavares and his decision to leave the New York Islanders in free agency. And you mentioned, you know, you referenced your own career and how hard it is to come to that decision. You know, Tavares, for whatever reason, I mean, obviously Toronto Maple Leafs fans are very happy. Islanders fans, some of them are a little upset. But since you've been through it, I mean, how hard is it really to make that sort of decision to leave a team that you've spent your entire career with up to that point?
It was a lot harder than I expected. I know that. You know, there's times during your career, different things are happening and you're saying, well, it'd be kind of neat to be an unrestricted free agent and be able to make those decisions. And, you know, when that time finally did come around for me, I found it extremely difficult. Things in New Jersey had been very good for me. Team had success. You know, and then this other opportunity to go out west, get a chance to play with my brother. Both of the situations looked really good. And, you know, you're kind of stuck there trying to make a decision as far as your playing future, and definitely not as easy as it sounds when you're not in those shoes. And that's what I found. And like I said, I'm, you know, it was a tough decision. I made the decision, and I'm just very thankful that it did work out.
Yeah, it certainly worked out, I'd say. Before we let you go, watching the game now, what excites you about the state of the game right now? And is there any player in particular that you enjoy watching?
I mean, it is fun to watch the game now. I really enjoyed the playoffs this year. You know, I probably watched more games this year than I have in a long time. You know, the storylines that were out there were a lot of fun. Watching a team like Washington that had been knocking at the door for so long to finally get rewarded, I think was great, because, you know, that's a great lesson that you just keep plugging away. A guy like Ovechkin and Backstrom and some of those guys that have been on that team and taking a bit of heat and, you know, over the years for not having success, and they just kept coming back for more, and they finally were able to do it. So that was obviously pretty fun to see. And then just the whole Vegas story.
Yeah, not unbelievable.
Much to say about that. I mean, that was entertaining and fun to watch. So the game, you know, I enjoy it. I get a chance to go down to the AHL in my job here with the Ducks and watch some hockey down there, and I enjoy that as well. So it's fun. It's also nice when you get home, you're not tired and sore, and you can just go to sleep and wake up the next day feeling good. So you're not a bad position.
You probably sweat more now living in California than you did playing 30 minutes a night in the National Hockey League in the Stanley Cup Finals. Just saying.
Oh, yeah. That's so funny.
But congrats, Needs. That's awesome stuff.
Yeah, congratulations again on having your jersey retired by Anaheim. That's going to be a special night for you and your family, and we appreciate you coming on and putting up with Rupper today.
No, absolutely. Good catching up with you guys, and enjoy watching you, and keeping updated on what's happening in the NHL, for sure. Thank you.